Hi students, we can continue exercise 17C. Now we can start question number 13 onwards. In a cyclic quadrilateral PQRS, angle PQR is equal to 135 degree. Sides SP and RQ produce meet at point A, whereas sides PQ and SR produced meet at point B. If angle A is to angle B is equal to 2:1, find angles A and B. Consider triangle APQ. This is A, P, Q. If you are considering this triangle, exterior angle PQR will be equal to sum of opposite interior angles. That means PQR is equal to angle QAP plus angle APQ. That is sum of these two angles. So exterior angle, this will be equal to sum of these two angles. Let it be equation number 1. Consider the cyclic quadrilateral PQRS. So exterior angle APQ, consider the cyclic quadrilateral PQRS, exterior angle APQ, this is the exterior angle APQ, will be equal to what? SRQ. That is, SRQ means this will be the angle. That is, we know exterior angle of a cyclic quadrilateral is equal to opposite interior angle. So that two angles will be equal. Let it be equation number 2. Look at equation number 1 and equation number 2. Substitute equation number 2 in equation number 1. That is, an exterior angle PQR, we can write it as PQR is equal to QAP as QAP plus, instead of APQ, we can write it as SRQ. So APQ, we replace it as SRQ. Let it be equation number 3. Next, consider this triangle. Which one? BQR. Consider this triangle. Same as this triangle. We can take exterior angle SRQ. SRQ, exterior angle, is equal to sum of opposite interior angles. So which are the opposite interior angles? This one, B, and this Q. That is BQR plus RBQ. Sum of these two angles. SRQ will be equal to sum of these two angles. Let it be equation number 4. Same as 2 and 1. Look at equation number 4. Angle SRQ is equal to angle BQR plus angle RBQ. Substitute this 4 in equation number 3. We have equation number 3 as PQR is equal to QAP. So QAP as QAP itself. Then instead of SRQ, we got it as what? SRQ. SRQ, we got it as BQR plus RBQ. So XRQ, we can replace it as BQR plus RBQ. This one. Replace that. So angle PQR is equal to QAP plus RBQ as RBQ itself. Plus, we can change BQR as 180 minus angle PQR. Why? Because look at BQR plus PQR. BQR plus angle PQR. Sum is 180 degree. So what about 180 degree? The total sum is 180 degree. So we can write angle. Here what we can write? Angle, which one? Angle BQR can be written as 180 minus angle PQR. PQR, 180 minus PQR, that is angle BQR can be written as total is 180, 180 minus angle PQR. I think it is clear. Once again, substitute this 4 in 3, we will get angle QPR plus QAP as QAP itself, then SRQ we can replace it as, in SRQ we can write it as BQR plus RBQ. So PQR we know it is 135 degree, so replace it as 135 degree is equal to QAP plus RBQ. RBQ. Then what about BQR? BQR is what? BQR plus RQP is equal to 180 degree. We discussed that. So total is 180 degree. RQP is 135. So what about this remaining angle? 180 minus 135. So it is equal to 45 degree. Total is 180. 180 minus 135 is 45 degree. So we can replace BQR as 45. BQR is 180 minus 135. This is equal to 45 degree. So 135 is equal to angle QAP plus RBQ plus 45. 135, this 45, left side it will become minus 45. QAP, look at QAP, look at the figure. QAP is given as angle A is equal to 2x and B is equal to x. Why? Because given ratio angle A is to angle B is equal to 2:1. So we can write angle A as 2x and B as x. So 135 minus 45 is equal to QAP. QAP we can write it as 2x plus RBQ. Look at RBQ, RBQ as x. So 135 minus 45 is equal to 2x plus x. So 135 minus 45 is 90 is equal to 2x plus x, 3x. So x is equal to 30 degree. That is the measurement of angle B is equal to x. That is B is equal to 30 degree and A is equal to 2 into 30, which is equal to 60 degree. Thank you.